Day two. Right, Bewley Motor Museum, here we go. Same term, right. Sorry. She wasn't happy with me. Wasn't a bad stay last night. Meal was reasonable. £45 for an Indian. Tell you what though, we just had a breakfast in Wetherspoons. How cool is this? £3 odd for a breakfast bap. Or you could have a full cup breakfast for £2.99. We had coffee and off chocolate. Two glasses of orange juice and two breakfast baps have come to £7. Anyway, so this is Lymington. We walked down to the marina last night. Little cobble streets and what have you. Very nice. Morning. Felt a bit more refreshed this morning. I was getting tired last night. Do you know, we only done 240 odd mile, I think it was. We done more than that in Scotland. Really felt it coming down. We done the A roads all the way down from the Wirral down to Lymington, down here. I thought, oh, it'll be a nice, you know, we get 3/4 of the way down. I think, oh, this isn't too bad. This is a breeze, this is. That last 30 mile, Jesus. Look, Griff boy, you're getting too old. Looking forward to Bewley. That wheels at Top Gear looks brilliant. All the old cars there. Thought we can have a look around the house as well. Allegedly. This New Forest is a lovely place. Really picturesque.
you can see on-screen cars with popular vehicles from TV and film. Directly beneath is the world of Top Gear, featuring many elements of the world-famous TV studio and a selection of vehicles that have been used and abused in the iconic program, as well as an exciting Top Gear simulator and radio-controlled car.
That's brilliant. Smaller than what I thought. It's a lot smaller, isn't it? I thought they'd have been bigger than that. That's that boat. Look at that. Unbelievable. Can't believe I thought it looked, I thought it was bigger than that. Oh, the hover van. Brilliant. See the state of that van, it's split in two there, look.
The Germans were now first and second.
Oh, they were the scooters, eh? Right, yeah. Be a panda. Normal. No. No.
we glide into the Motor Museum, we pass over the entrance to our wheels ride, which allows you to see, hear, and even smell over 100 years of motoring history. Opposite is Jack Tucker's, a 1930s period garage containing thousands of genuine motoring items.
The last time we did that battery and it cracked the pitch dark, it's a new garage, we've got to beat that. We could clean this place up, put a pot of paint on the walls, would be a match for Peterson's. We could get a motorcycle agency.
Peterson's have already got Norton, son. Somebody like Brian would look twice in a place like that.
What, you Imperial? Come on, they're great motorcycles. Maybe they let me have one, second choice.
The museum houses over 200 people, including veteran and vintage motors, sports and racing cars, and commercial vehicles. On the other floor, the motorcycle story takes you on a journey through motorcycling history.
So exhausting. Yes. The old Nortons and Triumphs. this is the flying car from Harry Potter. Yeah. A lot of bench there.
Yeah. It's like a lot of bench there, isn't
it? Yeah.
And they'll probably use a lot of that in the kitchen.
Another little house.
As we leave the station, you can see Palace House. Part of this building was the great gatehouse to Bewley Abbey. Beyond the house and gardens is the mill pond, for which reed used for thatching is harvested. The formal gardens that you can see are the Victorian Ornamental Kitchen and Vegetable Garden and the Victorian Flower Garden beyond. We are now passing through the monorail.
Okay. I hate gravel. Another fabulous day at Bewley. Brilliant. Anything I don't like? Gravelled car parks. Really horrible things. You okay? Hey? Get a walk. Huh. Well worth a visit. Why would you want to go fast when you've got views like that?